Hello friends, I am Dr. Avilas Naik. I welcome all of you to this MOOC on Academic Counseling for ODL Learners. In this video, we shall discuss different approaches to designing self-learning materials. We will mainly focus on three dominant approaches like tutorial imprint, reflective action guide, and problem-based learning. In the first approach, that is tutorial imprint, the learning objectives are clearly defined and the course contents they seek to teach a well-defined body of knowledge. The writer presents some input in the form of a text, diagram, or task and then sets an activity which helps the learners understand the contents being taught. An ideal unit usually consists of carefully controlled sequences of input, activity, and feedback. The self-learning materials, they simulate the presence of a teacher inside the classroom. The teacher gives some input, then asks questions or sets tasks inside the classroom. This approach is very useful for the text-based ODL. This approach is based on three main principles. First, every learning outcome should have at least one activity. Learning outcomes should have several activities, and learning outcomes should have reasonable number of activities with smaller outcomes. Now let us discuss the second approach, that is reflective action guide. This approach is a constructivist approach. The materials which are designed with the help of this approach, they aim to support the learners learn from their own experience. It could be from their work, and encourages them to learn by doing. The materials which are designed with the help of this approach contain broad aims, but we don't generally find precise learning outcomes. The learners are given projects, tasks, or activities which require them to engage with the materials or other people, like their peers or the people working in the field. Such materials encourage the learners to record and reflect upon their experience, maybe with the help of the learning journals. In such materials, the activities are open-ended. They are often based upon the experiences of the learners. This approach is very much suitable for designing and developing printed self-learning materials. Now let us discuss the third approach, that is problem-based learning. This approach focuses mainly on higher order thinking skills like critical thinking skills, like problem solving skills and deep learning. This kind of approach encourages the learners towards self-directed learning because in this kind of approach, learners are supposed to take responsibility of their own learning and the teachers act only as the facilitators. Thank you very much for your patient listening. Now watch the next video on online self-learning materials. Thank you very much.